How's this? How's this right here?
Down a little, right there.
Right there? Say, boat's in, boat's in.
Gentlemen, it is a privilege and a pleasure to introduce to you at this time the greatest star that has ever hit this island, that star of stars coming to us directly from Harlem, Miss Gertie.
Howdy, folks, howdy. I think you are all swell.
Welcome to Rita Dare.
Take this opportunity to, and on behalf of myself and my wife, to welcome you to the Paradise Hotel.
Consider us your humble servants.
Servants nothing, just pals.
Gee, Gertie, you've got a heart as big as gold. No wonder I'm crazy about you.
Same old Joe, still jiving. Say, how does it feel to be king of the Diamond Palace?
Now that you're here, baby, it feels great.
You're my million-dollar baby.
Gee.
Now, honey, I'd like for you to meet the kids. Kids, meet Diamond Joe, the greatest guy this side of Harlem.
Diamond Joe, this is a real pleasure. I'm Tom McCann, manager of the greatest show that ever left Harlem.
Glad to know you, Mac.
I'm Stella Van Johnson, but just call me Stella.
I'm Ruby. I'm Claire.
And I'm Choo Choo.
I am.
I'm Queenie.
I'm Clara.
My.
Come on,
my.
Break it up. Don't get too personal.
No need to worry about that.
Well, girls, I guess we'd better register and get upstairs. Let's go.
Pappy, I just told the folks they can have anything they want on this island. And the best rooms in the house for them. In fact, you're looking at the greatest little actress that ever left Harlem, Miss Gertie LaRue. See that she gets to service a lady like her deserves.
Mr. Jones, I'm powerfully happy to be a servant to so great a lady as Mrs. LaRue. I'm giving her the bridal bedroom.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Miss Van Johnson and I will bunk together.
That's
here, Pappy, you take care of this. Sonny, bring Mr. LaRue's bag. I'll take this.
Bring mine too, Sonny.
Now, Mr. LaRue, if you'll follow me, I'll show you to your room.
You better get some rest, honey. I'll see you later at the Diamond Palace. Yeah. Take good care of Stella.
Don't worry, Joe. Watch dog Stella. That's me.
Fine.
I'll be good.
Thanks, Joe.
Oh,
We ain't had a bride in a long time.
Well, maybe it'll bring me good luck.
You'll need it, huh?
This is a nice little upstairs veranda. Sort of a porch balcony. You can come out here at night and look at the stars and the moon. I used to love to come out here at night and just look. Besides, it's so hot on this island this time of year, you'll need all the air you can get.
Sure is hot. Say, there isn't any chance of anyone climbing that tree from the ground floor, is there?
What do you care? I wish some good-looking man would climb up here and get me.
Don't worry about that, girl. People don't bother you much on this island.
Well, it would be just my luck for it to happen to me.
Miss Bridges, as soon as our trunks come up, will you have the boy bring them in, please?
I sure will. Is there anything else you ladies need?
No, that'll be all.
Oh, by the way, Mrs. Bridges, where did you put the rest of the company?
The girls in one large room at the end of the hall. The boys are too dozed down. Are you sure I can't do anything else for you ladies?
No, thank you, Bridges.
That's very well, then.
You know, Gertie, I sure hope you like it down here. Because Joe's a regular guy. And he's going for you, too, in a big way.
Oh, Joe's all right. In his way. But I just don't like his way. He's not my type.
What do you think of this dump, Queenie?
Oh, I have seen worse.
Come in.
Excuse me, girls. I've just settled Mr. Rue and Miss Van Johnson. I thought I'd look in to see if you all were comfortable. If you need anything, let me know.
The main thing now is the rest of our baggage. The boy said he would hurry up.
I'll have the boy to bring him right up. The men folks are just too dosed up. I thought you all would like to be near each other.
Don't kid yourself. The farther we are away, the better we like it.
That goes for me, too.
I know this island isn't like Harlem. It's hot here and the mosquitoes are bad. But your girls will get used to it in a couple of weeks.
Well, I guess your girls will be all right. Don't forget, if you need anything, to call me.
Okay, I'm sure we'll be needing everything.
A couple of weeks don't sound so good to me.
Mosquitoes, she said.
I wish I was back in Harlem.
Oh, stop your griping. This place is different. It's got romance. I like it. What are you mooning about?
I was just thinking about Al. You know, it was terrible the way Gertie treated him. He sure was a fine fellow.
You said it.
You know, I just can't seem to figure Gertie out. She had everything she wanted, sitting on top of the world. Money, car, a big store. Al gave her everything. Treated her like a lady. No, she wasn't satisfied. Couldn't take it.
That's right. One of these days she's gonna get what's coming to her.
And that ain't no lie.
You shouldn't get so excited, Mr. Christian. Remember your heart, Mr. Christian.
Well, I never was so humiliated in all of my life. The nerve of that inspector going through our baggage piece by piece and letting that show troop go right by. I certainly will take this up with the proper authorities.
Yes, Mr. Christian, you're right, Mr. Christian.
Morning, gentlemen. I have only one room left. The show people have taken up everything I have. Could you sign here, please? Boy, you take these baggage to room 22, please.
Yes, sir.
What are you dressing up for? Where do you think you're going?
Well, what do you think?
Matt just got through telling you to watch your step. He told you to take it easy. He told you to get plenty of rest and be ready for rehearsal at 10 in the morning. He doesn't want you parading around, and he's right, too. We just got into this town, and we can't take no chances.
Oh, shut up. What do I care about Matt? He's only the manager of the show. I'm the star. I'm the big shot around here. Nobody tells me what to do. I tell them.
Mighty big talk, Gertie. But it's that kind of a big eye and a little you that always gets you into trouble. All you ever think of is yourself. And the worst part of it is the whole company has to pay for your dirty ways. We'd all be living in Harlem right this minute.
If it hadn't been, you hadn't given Al the...
Please, Stella, don't ever mention Al's name to me again.
Now, you listen to me, Gertie. I've been with you a long time. I saw you go from the chorus to the top. And if it hadn't have been for Al, you wouldn't have gotten there. Al was one of the greatest guys that ever lived. You didn't treat him right. You run him around like a dog. You weren't satisfied to be Miss Gertie LaRue, the toast of Harlem, and treated like a queen. No, you had to two-time him. You weren't satisfied to throw him over. You had to wreck him. But listen, Gertie, don't do anything down here, because Joe won't take it.
Dell, I ain't saying you're right, and I ain't saying you're wrong. I guess I've got it coming to me. Al was a great guy.
Ollie, stop preaching to me! Do you think I like being in this hot hole? Don't you think I want to get back to Harlem? I know I had to leave.
But don't worry, I ain't gonna do nothing. We'll stay here until this thing blows over, and 7th Avenue and 135th Street, here we come. I'll do just as you say. I think I'll take a little walk and look the island over.
Don't worry, honey. I'm through with all men.
Well, you gave us the worst rooms in the house. It's not right, I tell you. You gave that show troupe the best rooms, and we had to take what's left.
Why, I just don't see how I'm going to stand it. And we expect to stay here quite some time. Well, if we don't teach these people what sin is, we've got to be in more comfortable surroundings.
But, gentlemen, I gave you the best we have at the present. Mr. Rue's a lady, and naturally we favor her with the best.
A lady? The wonder God doesn't strike you dead. She's a painted trollop. You should have seen her on the boat carrying on with all of those men. She's a Jezebel, I tell you.
Yes, Mr. Christian. You're right, Mr. Christian.
Well, there she is, boys. And don't forget, she opens tomorrow night at the Diamond Palace. Don't miss the show.
Brother, we'll be there, and how?
She sure is class. Boy, what wouldn't I give to meet a dame like that?
Well, brother, there she is.
Hi, big boy. How are you, tight pants?
My, my, my. Man, the stuff is here.
Thanks, Joe, for showing me around this Diamond Palace. It's a great place. A wonderful setting for our show. I wish I had one like it in Harlem.
Glad you like it, Mac Ann. You know, I've got a big investment here. Otherwise, I'd be in Harlem myself, right in the middle of all those bright lights. You know, Gertie's coming here makes me realize what I've been missing all these years.
She's a great performer, but just between us, Joe, she's hard to get and hard to hold.
What do you mean, Mac Ann?
If you give her half a chance, she'll give a guy the runaround.
Oh, yeah?
That's why they call her Dirty Gertie.
Little wildcat, eh?
Well, I've got to go now. I've got to put these cards out.
Oh, yes. How about if you'd go up inside?
Sure thing.
Thanks, Max.
See you later.
See you around. See you around. Now, listen, Blues. Attention to me. Miss LaRue is the greatest star that ever hit this island. Now, that's rehearsal at 10 o'clock. And I want you to play her music as it has never been played before. I tell you, you don't understand, but here's a picture of her. Put it up in your room and dream about it.
What did you say her name was?
LaRue. Gertie LaRue.
Did you have another name?
Oh, don't worry about that. You just play our music. Do that.
Boys, I've heard so much about this place, I've just got to stop and give it a glance.
Don't know where we'd go around here if it wasn't for the Diamond Palace.
It's the hottest spot on this island.
Well, what do you say to having a drink with the lady?
Sure we will, Gertie. I'll say we will, Gertie.
Come on, what are we waiting for?
Hello.
Gertie, I hadn't expected you down so soon. This is a pleasure.
Thanks, Joe. I'd like for you to meet a couple of friends of mine. Big Boy.
Hello, Joe.
Night Man.
Glad to know you, fellas. Any friend of Gert is a friend of mine. This calls for a drink. Just have a seat over here.
Thanks.
Hey. Pee-wee.
Yes, sir.
Our little servant. The little servant. I'm happy to see you. I'm glad to welcome you to the Diamond Palace. Now, I'm not going to make a speech. All I'm going to say is, the drink's on the house. Oh, yeah. pardon me, fellas. Will you please excuse Gertie? There's some important business to talk about.
Sure
thing. Business for a pleasure. Don't stay away. Okay, Big Boy. I'll be missing you. Hold everything tight, man. I'll be right back.
See you,
Mr. Rue, this is Blues in the Night. He's my professor here. If you have any music for him to play, he'll be happy to do it for you.
Thanks. I'll take it up with you in the morning. Okay.
That guy sure looks like somebody I know.
Oh, you might know him. He's from the States.
I saw her before. It looks like her. I know her.
Gertie, why don't you sit down? Gertie, you know, I've been looking forward to this moment for a long time. Ever since I saw you do your striptease in Harlem 2 years ago. God, what an eye for.
Joe, you are certainly my type of a gentleman.
Oh, Gertie, I like that. And just for that, I have a little surprise for you. Nothing, Gertie. That's just the beginning. That's just a sample of what I'm gonna do for you later on, kid. You know, I'm falling for you in a big way. And I've just been thinking. Gertie, you're not listening to me. Why is it Blues in the Night? Why?
Tell me more about it.
Nothing to tell, Gertie. He drifted down here from Harlem a long time ago. I can't just remember how long ago. He's nothing but a barfly. But he sure can play that piano. Are you, Gertie?
No, it's that song. Take me back to a long time ago.
Oh, snap out of it, Gertie. What you need is this. I drink from a private stock. You'll like this, kid.
Thank you, Joe. This is just what I need.
I figured that that's what it was. Bottoms up.
Down the hatch.
Attaboy.
Oh, Mr. Christian, it's awful. It's just awful. I saw them with my own eyes. I peeked into the Diamond Palace, and sure enough, there she was, drinking and cussing and carrying on with that soldier and sailorman. And all of us were there, too, doing just like she was, only maybe worse.
Stop it, Ezra. I can't bear to hear any more. I must think of some course of action.
But I must tell you the rest, Mr. Christian. It's my duty. There's pictures all over town of this nasty woman. And all she's got on is a little... You know, a little tinsel or something. Everybody's looking at her and just pointing and laughing.
Stop it. I know my plan of battle clearly. I'll go to this LaRue woman, talk to her, reason with her. Then if she does not listen, I'll go to the governor and have him put her in a low-down court off this island. Send them bag and baggage back to Harlem. Yes. What I'll do.
Mr. Christian, you better come to bed. It's awful late. It's 3 o'clock in the morning.
No, I've made up my mind. The Lord's work must be done. I must talk to this woman alone. Go back to bed. Never mind about me.
I must call it a day. I have a rehearsal at 10 in the morning. And besides, you two had better get back to the barracks or else you'll be put in the brig.
I'll take that chance any day, honey. As long as I can be with you.
That goes for me too, Gertie.
No, ain't that pretty? Talk like that calls for a good night drink. You sure bring out my better nature. Big boy, you sure know how to kiss. I ain't been kissed like that since Elf.
Elf? Who is Elf?
Never mind, big boy. He's just somebody I want to forget.
We'd better be going, Gertie. You need to get some sleep.
Good night, honey.
Good night, boy. Sleep tight. Al. Al. What's the matter with me anyway, always thinking of Al? Why don't you get out of my life and stay out? Get out! Stay out!
Miss LaRue, I want to talk to you. Drink this.
I can't drink that stuff. What's the matter with you anyway?
Mrs. Rue, the Lord would be shocked if he heard you talk like that. Likewise, had he heard you talking to that sailor and marine, he would have turned away in shame. He has sent me here to help you. He is asking you, through me, to give up your life of sin. Your life with men will only lead to destruction. The wages of sin is death. Give it up before it is too late, Sister Gertie.
Take your hands off of me, you dirty psalm-singing polecat. If the truth were only known, you want me just like all the rest.
Have it your way, Miss LaRue. But you haven't heard the last from me. The Lord moves in mysterious ways, his wonders to perform.
Turn to Harlem, Al's there, and he'll be sure to kill you.
You know what, Stan? I could have sworn I saw Al tonight, standing looking at me in the moonlight. I had just taken a drink, and I could have sworn he was there. I could feel his hot breath burning my face. I could feel his long fingers clutching at my throat. I threw my last bottle of red eye at him, and then he disappeared. There was still another good drink in that bottle. I sure could use it now.
If you'll take my advice, honey, you'll see that voodoo woman that the girls were all talking about. They say she sure can tell you just what's gonna happen. But right now, you need rest. Rehearsal in the morning, a show at night. Get some sleep, honey.
She's here, Al. I saw her.
I know it's her. She called herself Gertie LaRue. I know it's her.
Hey, man. Wake up. You're talking out of your ear. Wake up.
Al, you're my friend. I told you she wasn't no good, but you wouldn't listen to me. You should have killed her.
Come on, Larry. Wake up. You ain't got no business talking about killing anybody.
Why am I?
Right in the Diamond Palace where you was last night. Uh-oh. Here come Mr. Joe.
Now, don't tell me you ain't been to bed yet. You got a rehearsal at 10 and a show tonight. Now, get some sleep, man. You won't be able to stand up.
I'll be all right, Joe. Just be me. I'll be all right.
Well, that's fine. Another thing. What is this song you played last night? That soft song I hear around here so much. Mrs. LaRue doesn't like it. It upset her no end. In fact, it made her sick.
It ain't much of a song, Joe. A pal of mine wrote it long time ago for a woman he was nuts about.
Who was this woman?
Oh, you wouldn't know anyway. She's no good rap.
Well, don't play it anymore. Miss LaRue doesn't like it. Now, get some sleep, man, and be sure to be at rehearsal at 10 o'clock, Larry.
All right, Joe. Leave it to me.
Okay.
I'll be all right.
Miss Christian, I hate to say it, but I'm worried about you. You didn't sleep at all last night. You rolled and tossed and said a lot of things I don't like to repeat. And besides, you ain't even touched your breakfast.
I'm not hungry, Ezra. This morning, I can see the path I must follow quite clearly. God will direct my steps. I'm going to the governor. Have him send this LaRue woman and all of her cheap rubbish off this island. They must not give their exhibition of filth tonight.
Well, maybe you're right, Mr. Christian. But I can't help feeling awful nervous about what's going to happen.
Don't worry, Ezra. The Lord will take care. I feel certain you know me and know my mission. And in all fairness to you, I feel it is my duty to give you a chance to close this show and send this LaRue woman and all of her devil mongers back to where they came from.
Yeah? Just suppose I don't.
Then I'll go to the governor of the island.
Listen, brother, I wouldn't do that if I were you. Come on, let's go inside and talk this thing over.
Nothing could induce me to cross this threshold. No amount of money could make me enter that den of vice. God's wrath would strike me dead.
Just what are you going to do about it?
That you will soon see.
Boys, I think it only fair to call your attention to the threats that are being made to close this show. Well, now, whatever you heard, just forget about it. Because nothing and nobody will close this show. I want all of you to know that the show will go today is Let Them Have It. In honor of this great star, Miss Gertie LaRue, coming to play at my Diamond Palace, I take great pride and joy in presenting to her this little token in memory of this most auspicious occasion.
Okay, gang, let's get in there. Now, let's go. Stell, come in a little closer, will you? Move over there. Get together. All right, now get set. Stay in your places. And now, Larry, music.
Show people be coming in?
Yes, it is. They've got to get some rest before going to the show tonight.
Excuse me, please.
Sure. Mr. Christian.
Yes, Ezra. What is it?
Mr. Christian, I just found out that those show people have been trying out their show all the morning, and that they're going ahead and give that show no matter what you say.
I'm not surprised at your report, Ezra. Been to the governor. I regret to say that he'll do nothing to stop the performance until he has seen the show with his own eyes.
That wicked man. But surely he wouldn't be seen setting a foot in such a vulgar dive.
At every turn I've been blocked. Now I must ask for divine guidance. He will show me how to rid this island of those willful sinners.
Is there anything I can do, Mr. Christian?
Yes, you can, Ezra. You stay here. I must closet myself and pray. I must commune with the Lord in secret. Oh, God. I beseech thee to show me the way. This woman, this sinner, this temptress of men whose flesh is weak. Please, Lord, tell me, must I stop this dreadful performance, this horrible exhibition of flesh? You know, Lord, I'd loathe to witness such a spectacle of filth. But if it is thy will, I will slip into the diamond palace tonight, unseen, and watch unnoticed this show of lewdness, that I may be better able to judge in thy sight. Tell me, O Lord, must I go? Yes, Lord, I'm listening. You want me to go. Then if it is thy will, I shall not disobey. Thank you, O Lord. Thank you. Amen.
I'm sure tired.
Oh, babe, a bad relation makes a good show.
So they say.
Gertie, sure, why the nervous?
Yes, she must have been drinking rotten liquor.
Come on, Gertie, don't fool around now.
That's right, Gertie. Big show tonight.
Okay,
get your ass.
Okay.
I brought you some flowers, Gertie. I'll be pulling for you at the show tonight.
Thanks, Tight Pants. I'll deliver every little movement to the Navy.
This ain't much, Gertie, but I just wanted you to know I'm thinking about you.
You're bringing me luck, big boy. Thanks a million.
Only the Lord would give me strength to conquer that woman.
I was just thinking, Mr. Christian, that I ought to see that show tonight. If I don't see that show, I can't tell you what an awful sinful thing it is. Don't you think I ought to see that show, Mr. Christian?
Heaven forbid. Don't even think of such a dreadful thought. You stay here tonight. Understand?
Yes, Mr. Christian.
While you were waiting down here tonight, Ezra, I had a talk with the Lord. I can't reveal to you what he said to me, but if I am late coming in, don't you worry. You'll know I have his work to perform.
Yes, Mr. Christian.
I'm going for a walk on the beach. The way of the transgressor is hard.
Yes, Mr. Christian.
Just between you and I, Stella, I'm not doing so bad. I got a diamond ring, a diamond bracelet, a swell scarf. Not to mention the flowers. Not bad, huh? I got a sugar daddy, a sailor, marine, and a preacher man if I want to take the time to work on him. How am I doing, kid?
Better go easy. Some things don't look so good to me. I don't like the way that piano player looks at you. And there's that preacher man. He's got a bad look in his eye. And another thing. I didn't like it when that black cat ran across in front of us when we passed that alley. You know, Gertie, I'm not trying to scare you. But if I was you, I'd go see that voodoo woman and I'd see her quick.
Yes, Del, I guess you're right. I must admit that black cat kind of scared me, too. I didn't say much, but I thought a lot. I've been trying to pep myself up all day. Ever since that guy played that tune, I've been feeling mighty funny. I believe you've got something there, Stella. I will see that voodoo woman.
Mrs. Bridges, could you tell me where I can find that voodoo woman I hear the girls talking so much about?
Sure thing, Mr. Rue. Sonny! I'll get Sonny to carry it, else you'd never find it.
You call me, Miss Bridges?
Yes. Carry Mr. Rue down the back way to Old Hager's shack.
Yes, Miss Bridges. This way, Mr. Rue.
Old Hager sure will tell you the truth, honey. And don't forget, she's got some special hoodoo powder down there. Keeps the hands away. Get some of that, too.
Thanks, I will.
That must be the boat over yonder at San Manland. Sometimes it brings supplies, and sometimes it brings people or passion.
Well, how much further do we have to
just
go?
Right there. Right there.
Oh. Okay, come on, let's get going.
No.
What's the matter?
No. I don't like to go over there. Ain't Hagel. No. You want to wait for you?
No, I guess I'll find my way.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
I want to know the truth about my future. What's the matter? Why don't you say something?
You better go home. It's better you go home. You should not know the truth.
I don't want to go home. Tell me the truth.
I hate to tell you. But you've done something bad. I see a man. He's mad at you. Looks like he's coming after you. I see blood. Everything goes dark. That's bad.
Say, girls, I wonder what's keeping
somebody out to find you.
I went to see that old voodoo woman. Certainly didn't tell me anything good. Oh, I got a feeling that old woman's a fake. Gertie, that's bad luck.
Thank you, folks. Thank you, one and all. In just a few moments, the show goes on, and you will see that star of stars, Miss Gertie LaRue, direct from Harlem, U.S.A. And now, on with the show!
Stop it! I command you to stop!
What do you mean by stopping this show?
Jesus drove the thieves out of the temple, and I shall do likewise.
Go to your room, Gertie. Lay low until this blows over. I gotta get back to the Diamond Palace to see about the damage.
Okay, Joe. Thanks a lot.
Okay.
What a wreck.
I've come to get you, Gertie.
Help! 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 I love you, Al. I've always loved you. Let's go away someplace. Any place. Start all over again. Kiss me, Al. Kiss me. Don't shoot us! Don't you? Al! Don't shoot us! Al!
love you, Gertie. I'll always love you.
Al, why did you do it?
I killed her because I love her.